Primate tourism has over the years contributed significantly to the economy through job creation and revenue. Gorilla trekking and chimpanzee trekking are some of the most enriching experiences that tourists fancy in Uganda. Addressing press about the One Health approach and conservation through public health, the Acting Commissioner of Wildlife Conservation in the Ministry of Tourism, George Oyesigiri, explained that despite the gorilla's population still being low, they have continued to fetch more revenue earnings to the country. It's contributing 50% to the country's revenue, amounting to 50 billion shillings annually.
The billion I talked about on average, that is before COVID, I need to highlight that, is only from mountain gorilla tourism. But we have other activities in other parks. We have chimpanzee tracking, the boat cruises, and we have concessions. So overall, before COVID, we were generating more than 100 billion across all the parks. But that's why I said the gorilla, revenue from gorillas contributes more than 50% of our revenue. That's why it is a very important resource for us as a country.
One Health is a concept that jointly addresses human, animal, and ecosystem health through a multidisciplinary approach that brings together veterinarians, medical and public health professionals, and environmentalists. According to the ministry, this will see the improvement of the livelihoods living around protected areas where gorillas are found. At the moment, the ministry has embarked on a wildlife policy review where an opportunity will be given to individuals with large chunks of land to take care of wildlife animals where they can also admit tourists.
Interventions like community engagement. In Kenya, in northern Kenya, they have what they call the conservancies, where communities manage large chunks of land. They have their own wildlife and they can admit tourists. We don't have that here, so we wanted to integrate some of those initiatives.
The wildlife policy will enable communities to appreciate wildlife animals and protect them. Report compiled by Juliet Namoya and Charity Marion Imnat for the news.